Thank you. तमेव शरणं वत्सः सर्वभावेन भारत तत्प्रसाद पराय शान्ति स्थानं प्राप्स्यसि शास्त्र। गीताते कृष्ण बोलते तमेव शरणं वत्सः, सब प्रकारे भगवान के शरणापन्न रहे हो, एरु फले तो ही परा शांति लाभ कर भी आता परम शांत तो काम प्राप्त हो। श्रीला व्रत का द्वितीय तहां दर्शन बोलते शास्त्रोक्त विषय के अनुष्ठाने विशेष रूप से यत्नशील होए तदनुसार कार्य निर्वाहन ये साधन स्पीहा देखा जाए तहां के वो श्रद्धालु कि तात्पर्य शास्त्र दिए बड़े अनुष्ठान भक्ति जन्म आप मध्य जत्न से होए श्रवण कीर्तन स्मरण बंधन पाद सेवन इत्यादि चातुर्मास व्रत आप मध्य कार्तिक मास विशेष आप मध्य चूल काटानो इत्यादि दाढ़ी कमानो इत्यादि दूसरी थाकते हैं। हमारे पूर्वाचार्य जी जे रकम होते आदर पूर्वक के चतुर्मास व्रत के कार्तिक व्रत के पालन करते हमराओ का अनेक देखी जैसे दाढ़ी को कामिए दे कामिए चतुर्मास व्रत करे ना कार्तिक व्रत सारा माता पूजा जाने की करे अते तराओ जैने यही सब पालन करे। प्रथम लक्षण शास्त्र के जखन विश्वास अधिक पे है जे शास्त्र जा बोलते हैं स्वार्थी और कोठा कोठा असंगति देखा जाए कहा के वो सामंजस्य कर दिखे एते कोनो संदेह नहीं से समय साधक शास्त्र पढ़े विशेष अनुष्ठान विशेष जप तखन भक्ति अंगुली के जपान भवते पालन श्री जीव गोस्वामी लिखे छे श्रद्धा उत्पन्न बोले सिद्धि हो का नहीं हो विशेष यत्न मान लो जे रकम भवते सुवर्ण प्राप्त करना चाहिए सोना प्राप्त करना चाहिए कत रूप चेष्टा कर ना बोले उनसे ना पावा गए तो पावा जिन अंत तक खूब चेष्टा करे प्राण पड़े वही रकम भावे थे भक्ति पालने जिन तार अंग पालन करवा जिन निरंतर उद्यम दिखाई निरंतर दिन रात परिणाम करना भक्ति शास्त्र के अनुशीलन करा वैष्णव मन के आदर करा सत्संग मन के जवा ये सब के भक्ति कहा के उद्यम सही आता सही उत्कंठा सही के ये सब के भाव में श्रद्धालु जहाँ तक श्रद्धा उत्पन्न रह गई थे सारे जेने सुने कोनो दिन महापुरुष प्रति कोनो अपराध करते पाए श्रद्धा भी कभी अपराध करे कारण पिता भजन सिद्धि प्रबल विरोधी एक जन्म वैष्णव अवज्ञा एवं अपराध नामापराध इत्यादि सावधान थाके श्रद्धालु व्यक्ति गणे संस्कार फले यदि विषय के संबंध हो जाए तथापि तहार के लिए धैर्य हो अनुताप हो एवं कोनो वैष्णव चरण के अपराध हो तहार के क्षमा कर दे श्रद्धालु भक्त माने ते कोनो दिन कोनो दुराचार देखा जाए ताले बोल बोल ये सावधान है यदि परपत्नी वक्तव्य অহিংসার মধ্যে লিপ্ত হয় না বলে যদি কোনো হয় তাহলে বুঝবে এইসব প্রমাণের দ্বারা জানা যায় যে শাস্ত্রীয় শ্রদ্ধা উৎপন্ন হলে সাধক ভজনের যে প্রবল বিঘ্নদায়ক এবং মহা মহত অপরাধ লাভ পূজা প্রতিষ্ঠা সবকে ত্যাগ করে ক্রমশ শ্রদ্ধা নিষ্ঠা রুচি এই এইসব ফলে কাজে করতে শ্রদ্ধাবান জন হন ভক্তি অধিকার যাদের শ্রদ্ধা রয়েছে তারাই হচ্ছে ভক্তির অধিকার উত্তম মধ্যম কনিষ্ঠ শ্রদ্ধা অনুসারে এই শ্রদ্ধা অনুসারে থেকে উত্তম কেউ মধ্যম শাস্ত্রী যুক্তি শ্রীলঙ্গ দৃঢ় শ্রদ্ধা যায় শাস্ত্রের যুক্তিতে নিপুণ শাস্ত্রের পালন এবং দৃঢ় শ্রদ্ধা যায় কিন্তু এই মধ্যমাধিকারী ভক্ত মানে সঙ্গে দেখো যাহা কোমল শ্রদ্ধা কোমল শ্রদ্ধা অন্য দেবতা দেবী উপাসনা করেন না আর ভগবত মূর্তিকে তিনি সবকিছু মনে করেন বৈষ্ণবদের আদর করতে জানে না কিন্তু মায়াবাদ নাই আর অন্য দেবতা দেবী পূজন করে না এইরকম ভাবে হলে শতান প্রসঙ্গে সঙ্গে আমার তত্ত্বকে জ্ঞান করাইতে পারে এইরকম হৃদয়ে আর কানের কথা সেই যাহা শ্রবণ করে তাহাতে মুখরূপে আনন্দ অবিদ্যা নিবৃত্তি হয়ে গিয়ে সবচেয়ে প্রথমে শ্রদ্ধা তারপরে ভাব ভক্তি এক একটা বলছেন শাস্ত্রীয় প্রমাণ দিতে এই শ্লোকেতে মহাপুরুষের সঙ্গে দ্বারাই শ্রদ্ধা প্রাপ্ত ভক্তি পালন করছে তখন দেখে একটু শ্রদ্ধা কিন্তু সেই শ্রদ্ধা কুমল যে স্বভাব কি শ্রদ্ধা
কৃষ্ণ ভজন the first step is called Shraddha. And already we have discussed so much about the symptoms of this faith or Shraddha. Therefore the first step in the path of Sabad Bhakti is Shraddha. It is characterized by Surupa Lakshan and Tatsa Lakshan. intrinsic symptoms and external symptoms. The Swarup Lakshana Vistara is Krishna Sevamasana, or the desire to serve Krishna, that is placed in the heart by the merciful Guru Vaishnava in the form of a seed. And the Tathasta Lakshana, the external characteristics of this faith, is unflinching belief in the words of Gurudev and the Vaishnavas. Then we have heard Shraddha Sattva Biswas Kohi Sudhudinis Chari Krishna Bhakti Kohila Sarvakam Kritahoi. That faith means the unflinching determination that I only have to please Bhagavan and perform devotion to Him, nothing else is necessary. Therefore, where this faith is there, there must be a concomitant endeavor to realize these things, to realize the statements of Hari Guru Vaishnava. Where there is faith, there must be strong endeavor. If there is no endeavor, means not so much strong faith. Therefore, this Sadhu Sangha will give Shraddha, that Shraddha will mature to Bhava Bhakti, and finally it will mature all the way up to Prema Bhakti. Devasi Jiva Goswami here, he states that this Shraddha and Saranagati are the same thing. Where we have Shraddha, there must be Saranagati. Where there's Saranagati, there must be Shraddha or faith. There is unflinching. Oh, because when one has faith in Sri Krishna, then one will surrender to Him, then one becomes fearless, like Prahlad Maharaj. So where there is faith, there must be surrender. So unflinching faith in the protection of Sri Krishna, Rajasati Biswaso, this is faith. So, where there is faith, then there must be appropriate endeavor to realize the statements of Scripture. When there is faith, then there will be an endeavor to perform the limbs of devotion, such as Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, etc. For example, where there is faith, there must be an endeavor to follow Chaturmasya, and especially Kartik month. In the 4 months of Chaturmasya, one doesn't cut one's nails, beard or hair, but we see some shaving their beards, etc. That means not so much faith. Therefore, whatever Shastra says is completely true. And if there appears to be some contradiction, then we must endeavor to reconcile those statements through association with high-class devotees. Where there is faith, there will be a special endeavor to follow, which is favorable for the cultivation of bhakti. Sri Jiva Goswami states that when faith or Shraddha awakens, whether one achieves perfection or not, one will still endeavor. An example is that many people try to make gold from bell metal by, what's it called? Alchemy. Even though we see very few people achieve success, still many people endeavor. In the same way, where there's Shraddha, there must be strong endeavor for Harinam, respecting Vaishnavas, and always to remain in satsanga. And we should be very careful to not make any offense to any Vaishnavas. Because the only thing that can really disturb our perfection in the achievement of devotion is Vaishnava Bharat. And we should be very careful not to neglect Vaishnava, respect any Vaishnava. And if we have done so, we must lament and beg their forgiveness. And even if we see some bad things in the character of Vaishnava, you should know that these will all be destroyed by Shraddha or faith. Therefore, this Shraddha will mature into Nishtha, which will mature to Ruchi, which will ultimately mature to Bhava and Prema. Therefore, the measurement of devotion is always taken by how much Shraddha someone possesses. Mahaprabhu said, Sradhajan Bhakti Yoyas Bhakti Adhika. Therefore, we should know that there are three levels of Vaishnava, the Kanishtha, the Madhyam, and Uttam. And we can understand what level someone is at according to their Shraddha. The Uttam Vaishnava is characteristic by being completely expert in the deliberation of Shastra, and able to apply all type of logic and reason to that, and he has unflinching faith. The Madhyamadikari or the middle class devotee, Yujmadikari will deliver the three worlds. The Madhyamadikari, they're not so much expert in Shastra or in logic and argument, but they are very fortunate because they have unflinching faith. And the Kanishadikari, they have a very soft faith, but they do not worship any other demigods. And they accept the Vikta, the devotee of Sri Krishna, but they do not know how to properly respect Vaishnavas. That Kanishadikari will also have no touch of illicit association with women, nor they will be afflicted by Mayavad or taking association with Mayavadis. Therefore, we should give our ear and hearts to the words of the Uttam Vaishnava. Sri Kapila Dev has said, Satamka Sangam Mama Bindavam Bambigos, Bhavanti Rikkhana Rasayana Katha. This Harikatha is like nectar. One should give one, take it into one's heart by the ears. By hearing this Harikatha, one will achieve Shraddha, then Bhavati, then Prabhavati. So one point here, sometimes we see someone who is very Balpurvak, means they're very much strong in their practicing of Sadhana Bhajan by force, but they have not achieved Shraddha by the association of sadhus. Therefore, they have not got real Sanskriya Shraddha or transcendental faith. This type of faith will not help us very much in spiritual life. But the real type of Shraddha is achieved by the association of Mahatsangha, or by the association of pure Vaishnavas. And this type of transcendental faith is completely indispensable in the practice of devotion. Therefore, the faith which does not come by satsangha, that is called Bhavapurvak Shraddha, is not very helpful for us. Go, Premananda.
The is my puppy author, Siddharth Goswami Maharaji Charnate Pushpanjali Vivo Tarakarti Parvo. Our Tarpari Sande Samyate Ajke Sri Anup Sanatam Gaudiyamat, Panpandi Mahadev, Shyam Sundar, Rimat Vaya Tarpari Charyasta. Go Pramanandu. Thank you.